everyone, this is a review of the brand new Mainstays Essential Oils Wax Melts that just came out at Walmart. I am reviewing 11 scents, but I believe there are 14. I was not able to find three of them, but I don't really think I'm missing out because these, for the most part, are pretty awful. The scents are kind of off, but most importantly, they just don't throw. The only good thing is that they, because I guess they're supposed to be natural, they're probably some type of a soy blend, but they're not soft or messy, which is good. So, and they're all white, because I guess they're all natural, but you can see they are hard wax. Although they are, when you take them out of the warmer, they do crumble a little bit. But it's not that really that bad. Whenever I see that wax melts are made with essential oils, I'm always concerned that they're not going to throw well. And that's because they usually don't throw well. So, and these are no exception. So they are 93 cents for 1.25 ounce. And they can be found in the essential oils and diffusers section of Walmart. Instead of with the wax melts, but that section is usually in the same aisle as the candles and the wax melts anyway. So I don't have the scent notes, but I'm assuming that if they're pure essential oil infused, that that's really the only scent, I would guess. Although with some of them, I'm not quite so sure. Some of them might have other scents or other notes or ingredients as well. So I will start with basil. This smells exactly like authentic basil, like you just rubbed a basil leaf with your finger. And I love this scent, although I don't think I want my house smelling like a salad. So it's a really nice scent, maybe to make you hungry for salads, but other than that, is really, I don't see the need to, again, have your house smelling like that. But essential oils are not really meant for scent. They're meant for, I guess, for, I don't know, to emotional therapy or something like that. But it's a nice scent, but again, not one that I want my house to smell like. Which is really not going to be a problem because the throw is like a 1 out of 5. It's, I can smell it from maybe a couple of inches away, maybe like a couple of feet away at the most, not even, maybe like a foot away. So it's basically, it wouldn't even do well in a tiny, tiny room, even a closet. So it's kind of useless. And I assume that because the throw on these is so bad that maybe they were meant to be used in conjunction with their oils because they do have the scented oils in all the same scents. Maybe you were supposed to like put a drop of oils in with the wax melts. So I looked at the instructions on the back of the wax melts and no, it doesn't say that. So that's not the way it's supposed to be. Next we have eucalyptus. This is a true authentic eucalyptus scent that almost has almost like a camphor type note. So it's really nice. It's great for clearing stuffy sinuses. But again, this one has a throw of 1 out of 5. You can barely smell it, even from like a foot away. So that's kind of useless for eucalyptus that's supposed to clear your sinuses. Frankincense. It's kind of I can't really figure out the scent. It's so weak on cold sniff. It's an earthy, woodsy, like a natural cinnamon type scent, but not really all that cinnamony. It's actually kind of nice, but throw is 0. Like I started melting it after like maybe a half hour, put my nose up to it from maybe an inch away. I smelled something. I mean, do they do quality control on these? Do they actually melt these to see if they can smell them? Because it's just, that's a waste. It makes me mad. Next, we have lavender. This is an authentic lavender scent with a hint of a medicinal sage-type note. On cold sniff, it's a little bit sweet, slightly more than real lavender, but when it's melted, much of that sweetness dissipates, and it's quite medicinal. I mean, I guess you could mix it with something else that's sweeter. The throw on this one is better. It's medium, like a 3 out of 5. So it would do well in a smaller, maybe a medium-sized room, but still not as strong as other lavender scents I've had. Lemon. This is not actually all that lemony. It actually smells like the lemongrass scent, which I'm actually going to review in a second. It's like the lemongrass scent, but slightly less sweet and slightly more bland. So if you have to choose between this one and the lemongrass, I would choose the lemongrass. But this one, the throw, is actually quite strong, like a 3.5 out of 5. But if you like this scent, lemongrass is the one to get. And there are only 2 scents in this collection that are worthwhile getting. Lemongrass is one of them. And this almost makes up for all the other scents. This may be one of the best scents I've ever smelled. It smells just like an upscale spa or a fancy salon. I don't know if it's an authentic lemongrass scent, because lemongrass is usually a soapy citronella type of lemony scent. This one doesn't have that citronella note, and it's actually rather sweet and not as lemony as other lemongrass scents I've smelled. I do get the soapy note and a bit of lemon, but there's another herbal note in there, not in a savory way at all, but more like maybe a smidgen of some kind of incense. It smells exactly like a scent from an old wax melt vendor called Lake Providence Lodge, which is now closed, and the scent was called Fancy Salon, which was one of my favorite scents ever, and I was hoping I'd find another one like it eventually, and I have. And this one, the throw, is bold. 5 out of 5, took over the entire house. It did dissipate within 2 hours, which was the case with pretty much all of these scents, well, except one. Weak throw, and they dissipated within 2 hours. But even though this one dissipated within 2 hours, I almost didn't care because it smells so good. I'm just going to have to hoard a whole bunch of them, buy a whole bunch, because it's an absolutely amazing scent. And like I said, I don't even mind so much that it only lasted for 2 hours. Now, lime. This is the second out of the 2 scents that are worthwhile getting. This one lasted all day, at least 12 hours, probably would have gone longer. So the lemongrass and the lime are really the only ones that are worth getting. So this is a fantastic scent that smells more like a super sweet lime beverage rather than an essential oil. It's also not as citrusy and tart as a real lime. Melted, it's super sweet, like lime syrup with extra sugar. It smells great, though, and would probably make a really interesting mixer with other scents like vanilla, lavender, and mint. And the throw is very strong. 4 out of 5. Might actually be bold. So somewhere between that. And again, this one lasted forever, so lime is definitely the one to get, and also the lemongrass. So I'm just going to quickly go through the rest of these because they're really not worthwhile either. So Mandarin is basically orange, and this is definitely an orange scent, but a little bland and with a bit of a grapefruit note, but the throw was 0. Couldn't even smell it from like an inch or 2 away. So peppermint. This is peppermint, but unlike an authentic garden mint, it's like peppermint candy, although not quite as sweet as a candy cane. And the throw was medium, like a 3 out of 5, so it would do well in a smaller room. Next is spearmint. This is an authentic floral. Yeah, floral. Not overly sweet, with a barely detectable smidgen of garden mint. It's pleasant, but it's not minty at all, and definitely not spearminty. And the throw was like a 2 out of 5. Very weak. I could smell it from maybe, 2 yards away. So might do well in a really small bathroom or something. And last we have tea tree. This does smell like tea tree oil, but it also has a eucalyptus note on cold sniff. It's a nice scent, but not something I would want my house to smell like, as it's quite medicinal. And the throw is 1 out of 5. Could barely smell it even from like a foot away. So, there you have it. Those are the mainstays essential oil wax melts. There are three scents I was unable to find. And if I do find them, I'll add them to the text version of this review. I couldn't find cinnamon leaf, I couldn't find patchouli, and I couldn't find sweet orange. Although if you got mandarin, I don't know what the difference would be with sweet orange, but yeah, so those are the three I couldn't find, but I don't really think I'm missing out because these were just really, except for the lemongrass and the lime, these were just terrible. If you can't smell them, what's the point? So if you want to read a text version of this review, just go to waxmeltreviews.com. And if you want to join our Facebook group where we discuss all different brands and scents of store-bought and retail wax melts, like the Mainstays and other Walmart wax and other brands of store-bought wax, just join our Facebook group and you can find the link underneath this video and on our website at waxmeltreviews.com. Have a good day.